We meet again at the strangest of times, young Ekon. So do you serve the Earl of Bristol now?
Old Bridget. What are you doing here?
Your friend, the wise Ekon. She sent me to warn you.
Lady Ashbury? You know her? Tell me what's going on.
The lady approached me but a few nights ago, wanting to meet the sewer skulls. Once she questioned Harriet Jones, she agreed to help us.
Harriet Jones is still with you then? How is she doing?
Harriet remains angry, but is recovering slowly. Her mind is twisted, but at least her body is healing.
Tell me what is going on.
The lady asked us to keep an eye on your mortal doctor friend while you were away. We spotted the hunters. They were discussing plans to attack tonight.
Wait, slow down. I need to ask you something.
I'm listening, but I do not have time to waste, so be quick.
How did Elizabeth find you?
She presented herself humbly at our gate and asked if we knew of any ancestral vampires hiding in London. She asked about Ascalon. She asked about many things.
Why did she come to you?
I am Old Bridget, the buried memory of the city. She sought the silent truths. Truths I have kept hidden for so long.
What do you think of her?
Her soul is good, yet tainted with a deep sadness and the scars of ancient wounds. Time does that to us immortals, for we have so much to dwell upon.
Where is Lady Ashbury right now?
She said she will go home. She needed to speak with some old friends first, though. Do not worry, young Ekon. She is no fool, and just as strong as you.
Why do I feel like Lord Redgrave was particularly irritated to see you? Far more so than the average Skull, if I may say.
Because I used to know him quite well. And he is afraid I may remember who he really is.
You're Elizabeth's informant. You're the one who told her about Lord Redgrave's lies regarding his lineage.
Yes, but my words were not meant to hurt or threaten. I simply told the story of the sewer skulls, and of so many other forgotten children.
No time to lose, then. I must go there right away.
I shall return to my den. Have you a message for the lady? Should I see her before you?
Tell her I worry about her.
Do not, for she has had strength and wisdom for so much longer than you. Go now and take care, young Ekon, for the flames are rising.
blood. This is despicable. I have this thirst for blood. I can't believe I'm doing this. I have this thirst for blood. This is despicable. Good evening, Miss Teasdale. How have you been since you returned home?
Dr. Reid. Oh, thank God you returned safely from these awful streets. I was so worried about my father that I left without thanking you properly.
Please don't mention it, miss.
Good. I found him, you know. My dad. Or what was left of him. I think my abductor intended to do the same thing to me.
Do you need my medical attention, miss?
I don't need your help, specifically. I can assure you there are many competent doctors around.
I have no doubt about it, but I'm offering you my help anyway.
All right then, but please leave me alone for now.
Goodbye, Miss Teasdale, and be careful. Until we meet again.
It's always been your house, Dad.
Women die too in this war!
Good evening, Miss Ashbury.
And good evening to you, Dr. Reid.
Do you need my medical attention, Charlotte?
Indeed. Unlike you and my mother, I can still become ill.
Oh, you cannot imagine how relieved I'd be to catch a cold again.
My mother once told me the same thing. I sometimes wonder if she's forgotten what it feels like to be ill.
Goodbye, Charlotte. Give my best regards to your mother when you see her.
She's been quite busy these last few nights. I suspect you may see her before me.
Hello, Venus.
Hello, Jonathan. Please, come in.
At least you survived the Great War.
What do you need from me, Jonathan?
Do you need my medical attention?
It would appear that old habits die hard, my dear. I would appreciate your help, as always.
And I'm happy to give it to you, as always.
Thank you, Jonathan.
Goodbye for now.
They were such a beautiful family.
Good evening, Mr. Kamara.
Good evening, Dr. Reid.
Do you need medical assistance, sir?
Don't believe that I'm the kind of man with a fragile constitution. I'm afraid my imprisonment has done more harm than I thought.
There is no need to be ashamed. We are all equally vulnerable to this disease.
Yes. I know now life is as precious as it is fragile.
Goodbye, Mr. Kimura. Take care. Good evening, old chap. Are you all right?
I won't lie to you, Johnny. I'm not a well man.
Do you need medical assistance, Clarence?
It's a little late for visiting hours, don't you think?
What can I say? I haven't lost my old habits.
I hope we're talking about the same habits, old friend.
You need some rest, Clarence. You should try to sleep.
Good evening, Dr. Reid. A great night, what?
Do you need medical help?
You would save my life, Dr. Reid. I have not felt so bad in many years.
Don't worry. There is nothing serious to fear. I have seen far worse, I can assure you.
I cannot imagine the pain these people must face, then. You have my gratitude, Doctor. This disease has ruined my appetite.
I may have a look at your goods, Mr. Russell.
Good evening, Dr.
Have you any news on Aloysius Dawson?
I will never see him again in my shop, it seems. I did not realize how much his health had deteriorated. In the end, not even money can protect you from death.
Goodbye, Mr. Russell. I'm sure you'll take care of yourself.
Women of all countries, unite!